Hey, how's it going today, y'all? This is Josh with the Fun Times Guide. I am going to see what happens when I clean coins with soda. I have never tried this before, and I'm not really a big fan of cleaning coins for various reasons. One of the big reasons being the fact that when you clean coins, you damage the surface and lower the value, and you basically impair the coin for the rest of its existence because it won't be original. But I've seen a lot of forums where people are trying this out, where they use Coke or Pepsi or other sodas to clean their coins. And I thought, well, what would happen if I did this? What would the results be? So yesterday I went ahead and I poured a little bit of soda into a plastic cup and I placed it in there. So I got a quarter, I've got a penny, a dime, a nickel, the four most commonly encountered coins in circulation or pocket change. And I wanted to see how they would turn out after 24 hours in the soda bath. And as you see here, I actually have the coins partially submerged so we could get kind of a side-by-side comparison of how the coins look before I clean them versus after they've been in the soda wash for 24 hours. So now we're gonna see exactly how these coins turned out. So I'm here with a sink with the stopper pulled up so that nothing goes down the drain as I rinse off the soda from the coins. And we'll see how these all turned out. So let's go ahead and pull up the first coin. Here's a quarter, and let's see how 24 hours in a soda bath did. And well, the reverse or the tail side looks kind of the same. There's a little bit of difference here on the obverse. You'll see there's some staining here or patination, patina. The whole quarter kind of looked like this. It had that gray base with some greenish and brownish patina. I don't know if the soda works so well in getting the quarter cleaner. But I do see some improvement. There's a little bit of a line on the coin showing a difference left and right. So yeah, it made a little bit of an impact, not a huge impact. Let's try some other results here. Let's see, this is a dime. Let's see how the dime looks. And yeah, marginal difference. I think I see a line maybe this way. This being the submerged part, that the unsubmerged part. The reverse looks the same. The obverse or the head side, I don't know if it made a big difference or not. I do see a little bit of a line. Okay, here we go. There's a little bit of a line right here on the right. So the right side was the submerged side and it looks a little bit lighter, but not a huge difference. Let's try the nickel. All right, there's the nickel. And let's see how this nickel looks after 24 hours in a bath of Pepsi. And all right, now here we go. Wait a minute. Let's see. Oh, okay. So the left was the submerged side on the reverse, the right unsubmerged. It is lighter. So as with a quarter, that kind of darkish patination was removed. Yeah. Okay. So the left side on this case, here with the obverse, that was the submerged side. There's a difference. This side, the right side, was not submerged in soda. And yeah, same over here. So you can see there definitely was a lightening of the surface and a removal of the patination. Now, we've got the penny. Bear in mind that while these coins have very similar kinds of copper and nickel compositions, the penny, in this case, being a 19, what date was it again? It was a copper, yeah, 78, and wow, okay. It was a 1978 penny, which was the 95% copper, 5% zinc composition, the old bronze, and look at that. Now, you can see here the penny definitely was affected by the Pepsi. Look at that. The left side, which was the submerged side, was in the Pepsi, and it's a lot lighter than the right side is, which you can see here has the original brown patina, which actually in my eyes, in many collectors' eyes, this is the more desirable color here is the one on the right, the kind of brown chocolate color. That's what most collectors would be vying for. And note too, the reason why the reverse is completely clean, whereas the right has that definition there. I noticed that when I put these coins up against the sidewall of the cup, especially the penny and the dime, that the soda being up against the side of the cup actually had submerged most, if not all, the reverse side of the penny and the dime. So I'm looking really at the obverse here, in this case, especially on the penny, to see the difference. And there's a clear difference. The Pepsi did clean the penny quite effectively. We saw probably lesser results, lesser definition between the left and right on the nickel, dime, and quarter, but cleaning pennies with soda definitely does a job if that's what you're trying to do. So there you have it. I'm gonna go ahead and rinse these coins off with some running water, get all that soda off, because these coins don't wanna live too much longer in a soda existence. And we'll go ahead and get these coins here rinsed off and pat dry. Notice I'm not gonna rub these coins with the towel. I'm just gonna go ahead and pat them dry so as to reduce any friction on the coin and thus not impart any hairlines. If you wanna clean your coins with soda, it works, especially in the case of pennies or copper coins. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it interesting. I definitely found this quite fascinating, really, how the soda worked. Wish you all the best in your collecting adventures, and take care.